It's good to have to join us on Nationwide on the network service. My name is Ogechi Paul, and it is on this sad note that we report that the National Emergency Management Agency has confirmed the death of 8 people and 14 injured in a blast around Muruna Garage, Maiduguri, Borno State. The bomb blast occurred at the early hours of today. NEMA officials were drafted to the scene of the incident, and the injured persons were evacuated to specialist and teaching hospital, Maiduguri. Well, the Nasarawa State House of Assembly has lifted the suspension placed on 6 members for gross misconduct that lasted for over 6 months. This followed the presentation and adoption of the report by the ad hoc committee that investigated their misconduct at plenary. Correspondent Ahmed Ondas has more on the report. Well, we're sorry we do not seem to have audio on that report. The need for reforms and a holistic approach to judicial system have been identified as the ingredient for an independent and corrupt-free judiciary in Nigeria. These were some of the views of guests on NTA's current affairs program, Good Morning Nigeria. Salihu Abdullahi has a report.
The arrest of some judges and justices by the DSS over alleged corrupt allegations continue to dominate discourse on the public domain. While different groups and individuals have expressed their positions on the development, discussants on NTA's Good Morning Nigeria describe it as unfortunate, as it does not only affect the personality of those who are involved, but the entire judiciary.
That in the light of this desecration of the Temple of Justice, that the Constitution should be amended to allow judges to be able to return to practice.
Because whatever I do to a judge now will affect the sanctity of the judicial system. Even the sitting judges, it will affect their confidence and make them worry of living up to their offices.
Because once the public loses confidence in that supposedly last hope of the common man, there's nothing left. We are going back to the jungle, and the survival of the fittest will be the rule of the day.
In the quest for sanity and corrupt-free society, the guests say the Nigerian Constitution needs to be amended to check undue interference of politicians into the judicial process, adding that the judiciary should also make efforts to check corruption within the system.
It's good that the NJC is strengthened, there's reform, but they don't also have investigative powers, except they have to draft in detectives from the police and SSS.
The human rights of the people, of the resources of the people that are being carted away, not just by judges alone, citizens must rise up.
The guests say supremacy of the judiciary as the third arm of the government needs to be entrenched to uphold internal mechanism as viable option to providing holistic approach in all matters. In Abuja, Salihu Abdullahi, NTA News.
The federal government has appealed to Nigerians to take the path of honor by not allowing their emotions and sentiments to becloud their sense of patriotism in respect of the recent surgical operations aimed at ridding the judiciary of corruption. Minister of Information and Culture, Lai Mohammed, made the appeal while briefing newsmen after the Federal Executive Council meeting presided over by President Muhammadu Buhari. He said there's no intention whatsoever by the government to intimidate either judges or the judiciary, but to sanitize the system of corruption, and in the process, it is not unusual to step on sensitive toes. Tithas correspondent Adamu Sambo reports that the council had approved the completion of 10 megawatts wind farm project in Katsina, as well as ongoing federal secretary projects.
Do judges have immunity? The answer is no. Can judges be arrested? The answer is yes. Have judges or serving judges been arrested in Nigeria? The answer is yes. Justice Ikomi was arrested and tried. Majority Rauf Fugaji was arrested, tried, and convicted. Now, the next question to ask is that what is the proper procedure for arresting anybody or especially judges? There must be properly executed search warrant. Was such presented, the answer again is yes. People have tried to model the fact about when do you search, you know, a person's house. The truth of the matter is that under the new criminal justice, the criminal justice law, you can search anybody, anywhere, anytime.
The increasing rate of kidnappings in recent times, crime experts say, can be tackled from all fronts, especially with intensified security and stiffer punishment for anybody found culpable. Tileto Ezirike reports that this was part of submissions on NTA's Current Affairs program, Tuesday Live.
Nigeria, like many nations, is faced with the challenges of kidnapping and hostage taking. Many say all the vices like armed robbery are the aftermath of the civil war, which are fast becoming the order of the day, with painful tales and infringement even in rural communities. The development that has given rise to questions whether the nation is under police to curb crimes or what has happened to joint military patrol and how well are human and technology applied in tackling the issue of kidnapping.
I will want to see an immediate deployment of at every 5 kilometers of ready armed policing, cut off their supply lines, and also to protect those communities that will give us information.
If we occupy the space, having identified areas that are prone or that are ready-made for these kidnappers,
all right,
then there are likely possibility of them not finding it easy to come,
okay,
and perpetrate their crime, and also trying to restore back this family value system.
How many people, after going through the horrors of kidnap, who want to appear before the court? 90% of the cases we charge to court, witnesses don't come up. So at the end of the day, the kidnapper is found on the street, probably with one technical word or the other. In advanced countries, you have the parole system. Once you are thrown there, you can't come out in the next 25, 30 years.
For others, the society and especially custodians of morals cannot be exonerated of the blame, particularly against the background of cherished values of family name.
And how this government will do this, to lay the groundwork so that in 10 years, this problem does not get exacerbated. In 20 years, we don't become another Mexico.
There must be something we instill in our own children, whether we like it or not, to tell them that patience is a value. Hard work is a value.
Analysts strongly believe that kidnapping is alien to the nation's ethical values that should be addressed through the entrenchment of right reward system, good leadership, and role models, as well as shunning the get-rich-quick syndrome. Tilatu Ezirike, NTA News.
Well, thank you, Tilatu, there. Joining Lagos now, Governor Ambode's 2016 quarterly town hall meeting holds there. Abdullahi in that center brings us details. Hello.
Hello, and thanks for joining us in Lagos. Lagos State Governor Akinwumi Ambode says the state government has concluded plans to disburse the much-anticipated 25 billion naira employment trust fund and other empowerment programs initiated by his administration. The governor made the disclosure at this year's third quarter town hall meeting held at the indoor sport hall of the Teslim Balogun Stadium, Surulere, Lagos. Nasasula reports.
The governor said the funds for the programs targeted to assist youths artisans, and the needy to become self-reliant have been provided. Hence, beneficiaries would start getting support from the last quarter of the year.
Our guiding principle is to always channel our resources to areas and sectors that are positive.
Neighborhood watchers, with new recruits expected to earn at least 25,000 naira monthly with other allowances.
We're not happy that we're having cases of kidnapping in Lagos, and then all efforts that we're trying to do is to make sure that as we move towards the Christmas period, we scale up our efforts in ensuring that the city is safe.
Also speaking during the interactive session at the event, Oba of Lagos, His Royal Majesty Oba Riwon Akiolu, lamented the suspension of a bill seeking special status for Lagos by the Senate.
What we need to do now is to have a Lagos local government security committee to recruit able-bodied men who will operate directly under the divisional police officer.
Governor Ambode, however, expressed optimism that the bill would be reactivated and presented again, saying the success of the bill was in the overriding interest of Nigerians. In Lagos, Nosa Osula, NTA News.
To health matters now, creating a strong multi-sectoral partnership that will facilitate national response to the control of HIV among adolescent and young people has been described as a viable tool for preventing the spread of the virus in Nigeria. This was part of the message by the Director General of the National Agency for the Control of AIDS, Dr. Sani Aliu, to a day workshop on HIV and AIDS response. Joy Kenagbakoya has details.
The aim of the workshop is to design a strategic framework that will assist in improving the rate of response to adolescents with HIV and also sensitize stakeholders on their roles of partnering with NACA and state agencies in the fight against AIDS. These caregivers believe that AIDS, which is the number one cause of death in Africa and second globally, can be reduced to the barest minimum when the level of awareness increases among youths.
We're ensuring that people get to know about the adolescents and young persons. People get to know about the HIV prevention strategies.
Sexual cohesion, gender inequality, child and forced marriage, poverty and transactional sex are some of the factors responsible for the spread of HIV in Nigeria. An aggressive approach, they say, can be adopted to win the war.
Tragedy in place is called 1999 Initiative. What it means is that you're going to screen all the people that are living with HIV, 90% of them, by 2020. They should know their status. By those people that know their status, they must have treatment by 90% of them.
When there are no specific strategy addressing HIV prevention issues among them, then we are not really winning the fight against the control of HIV/AIDS.
They also agreed that all hands must be on deck to assist adolescents living with HIV through effective awareness campaigns, centralized database, and the provision of funds to the appropriate authorities for healthcare delivery. In Lagos, Joy Ken Abakpoya, NTA News.
Many thanks, Joy. And those are our top stories at this hour. It's back to Ogechi in Abuja, who has more reports. Ogechi, over to you.
Yeah, thank you, Abdullahi. Continuing now, two politics-related bills passed through second reading on the floor of the Senate Wednesday. Waziri Zayanu reports that the first was that for an act to provide for the establishment of the Nigeria Political Parties Debate Commission. The second is a bill for an act for the regulation and registration of lobbyists in Nigeria and other matters connected therewith. Details will come in our subsequent bulletins. The first transfer pricing regional meeting of ECOWAS member states is holding in Abuja. Lydia Basso reports that the meeting, which is geared towards building a strong investment climate across West Africa, has over 60 participants, including tax administration and tax policy officials.
The Federal Inland Revenue Service,
FIRS, ECOWAS, and World Bank Group are hosting the event under the European-funded Improved Business and Investment Climate in West Africa project. The project seeks to address a range of investment policy issues that constitute barriers for the private sector to invest efficiently across the region.
Taxation is the only way to go. The issue of taxation is not only important to West Africa, but the world all over.
The transfer pricing component of the project is an example of the World Bank's initiative to support domestic resource mobilization by helping countries to protect their corporate tax base from profit shifting.
A very clear example of our commitment and cooperation in these matters is the project, the Improved Business and Investment Climate in the West Africa project. Our contribution is 7.7 million euros.
The event is an opportunity for ECOWAS countries to share their experiences of introducing and implementing transfer pricing rules.
This forum has two focuses. One is to improve the level of tax administration, to exchange ideas, and then show the tax administrators within the West African sub-region how to deal with these issues.
The transfer pricing program was launched in November 2014. Lydia Bassi, NTA News.
Joining Joss now, NDLEA destroys cannabis worth 6 million naira in Plateau State. Femi Chetin Joss is standing by to bring us details of this and more. Hello, Femi Chit.
Hello and welcome to Joss. The Plateau State Command of the National Drug Law Enforcement Agency has destroyed cannabis worth 6 million naira in Zampit village of Shandam local government area. State NDLEA Commander Ngozi Madubike made this disclosure while parading 8 suspects in connection with the cultivation of the substance, who were paraded at the command's headquarters. The commander explained, were arrested as a result of intelligence reports on the drug farm cultivation by some people in Zampit village. Madubike disclosed that a team of 28 narcotic operatives, both from the state headquarters Jos and Shandam area command, including a backup of 27 officers and men of the 332 artillery battalion Shandam, swung into action, destroyed and burnt the farms within the settlement.
They were also able to arrest the suspects, the owners of the farms, about 8 of them, including a woman who is said to be married to one of the cultivators who is at large.
Among those arrested are 8 males and 1 female who is a nursing mother. Exhibits recovered are 2 double barrel, 1 single barrel gun with 5 cartridges and 2 7.5 rounds of live ammunition.
Government of Plateau and all well-meaning citizens of this state to join this agency in the fight against drug abuse and trafficking.
She also urged citizens to provide the command with useful information in ensuring that the state is rid of drugs. In Jos, Femichit Omoniwa, NTA News. Governor Simon Lalong says government will look into the possibility of providing the University of Jos with a firefighting vehicle to avert any reoccurrence of the fire incident which destroyed the institution's library complex. The governor said this while sympathizing with the university community over the unfortunate incident which occurred last weekend. Correspondent Paul Dama reports.
Governor Simon Lalong, in company of the Deputy Governor, Professor Sonny Tudan, and some members of his cabinet, were shown the first floor of the building where the library and the departments of political science, sociology, psychology, economics, management science, and accounting were located. The first floor housed offices. All of that have now been reduced to ashes. Governor Lalong, who was visibly shocked by the magnitude of the damage, described it as a colossal loss not only to the university but to the state and the nation. He promised that appropriate measures will be taken while assuring that he will get in touch with the presidency for prompt intervention.
Most of the things, you can't get them again. Many of the books written by the professor, some of them are dead. You can't get them to write the books again. But I know that when things happen like this, we put ourselves under prayers, we put ourselves on our knees and pray to God to avert further occurrences.
The governor also commended the bravery of the students and firefighters who worked tirelessly to put out the fire. Vice Chancellor of the University, Professor Sebastian Memoko, informed the governor that students of the institution are at present writing their first semester examination, and a lot of materials, including examination scripts and question papers, were destroyed. Professor Memoko, while appealing for urgent intervention in the area of infrastructure, said a team of experts have been constituted to carry out an integrity test on the building to ascertain its safety, as alternative arrangements have been made for venues for exams. In Jos, Paul Dama, NTA News.
And it's a wrap from this end. Ogechi, it's back to you for more news.
Thank you, Femi Chit. Minister of Environment Amina Mohammed says action-oriented efforts by all will enable Nigeria to sustainably manage the nation's marine and coastal ecosystems towards reducing poverty, enhanced food security, and overall socioeconomic growth of the coastal communities. She said this at the opening ceremony of National Consultative Meeting and Draft Additional Protocols to the Abidjan Convention in Abuja. Joseph Johnson reports.
The state of the environment is often a mirror of activities carried out on land, and such activities ranging from industrial and agricultural production to daily domestic routines affect the health of the ecosystem and the people that depend on it. Regardless of the fact that the Nigerian coastal and marine environment account for over 50% of Nigeria's economy, the ecosystem is plagued with problems such as pollution, global climate change, and others. Towards ameliorating these problems, environmental experts here are fine-tuning the draft protocols which will enable national action plans to be developed and implemented at the country level.
So please, experts, if we really mean what we say, the protocols that we produce, allow us to take the actions we need to destroy the ivory, to send a signal, to ban the export and logging of wood when it is detrimental to my country and my people.
Each country can own those protocols and domesticate them, implement them, then there will be a contribution to save those assets and to adapt to climate change.
Regional and international partners will be expected to present key recommendations at the end of the two-day program. Joseph Johnson, NTA News.
Well, the need to fully utilize the about 260 dams in the country for aquaculture, farming and livestock for food sufficiency was part of the resolutions reached at the two-day workshop organized by the Nigerian Society of Engineers in Abuja. Adebula, Brooklyn Sunday, further report.
It is on record that about 70% of the Earth's surface is covered with water, and Nigeria's about 924 square kilometers land area is made up of about 13,000 square kilometers of water. Over the years, Nigeria has had its own fair share of flood, one of the problems associated with water. And following some pockets and projection of flooding in Nigeria this year, these experts gathered to examine the challenges and opportunities in dams and to proffer solution to flooding in the country.
Increase in Nigerian population and socio-economic needs will continuously raise the requirement for water, food, and energy consumption. This is the time to use engineering to drive the change agenda of this administration.
Minister of Environment and that of Water Resources speak on government's efforts to mitigate the challenges.
Certainly, the Ministry of Environment has a number of programs. One of them, the New Map program with the World Bank. The real response is right at the very beginning to prevent it by better land use and watershed management.
Let me also inform you that the Federal Executive Council last month approved the National Water Bill, National Water Policy, and National Irrigation and Drainage Policy. And when that bill is passed into law, it will help solve many of the problems slowing advancement in the water sector.
The two-day workshop also dwelled on effective utilization of reservoir infrastructure. In Abuja, Adebola, Brooklyn Sunday, NTA News.
Well, this is to let you know that you can watch this news live online via the NTA mobile app, which you can download on your Android device at the Google Play Store. or at the Apple Store if you use devices with iOS. This is Nationwide on NTA. We now take a break for some messages. The news continues shortly.
When has it reached this? Much less this. And this. And this. And this. Help reclaim our commonwealth. Lend your support to the fight against corruption for a better Nigeria.
Now, you can hold that dream occasion without stress. Horizon Caterers will provide answers to all your catering questions. Exquisite hall designs, mouth-watering and nourishing local and continental cuisine. Suitable for all types of ceremonies, including weddings, AGMs, business luncheon, cocktails. Name it, we can bring it. Our chefs and executive waiters give your guests that unforgettable experience in service. Our service covers all states of the Federation. Call us today to book your occasions. 0805-502-9637. 0803-450-9726. 0909-9708-111. Horizon Caterers. Experience catering beyond the horizon.
Who are you and what is your predicament?
Please, I'm looking for Candy. Who is living here? In this compound?
Oh no, this is a premises. A compound is an amalgam of chemicals, and there is no Candy living in this premises.
This week on your award-winning comedy series, Professor John Bull, starring Kanayo Okanayo, Mercy Johnson, Queen Wokoye, Funky Malam, Bimbo Akintola, Ime Bishop, Yomi Fash Lanso, MC for God.
Who was you? What was you found?
Eh? Auntie Alupatio. I going to look for my sister. Anu Luapo.
Anu. He was found in a place called Mate. Okay?
Say somebody.
She's definitely not my sister.
Shut up! Asiocha!
Professor John Bull, fasten your seatbelts this Tuesday and Friday, 8:30 to 9 p.m. on NTA Network International and Star Times. It's absolutely bombastic.
Over and out.
The largest data network, Globe, grandmasters of data.
The ETV National Children's Expo for Scientific, Technological and Artistic Inventions is in its 10th edition. We are set to make history again, live at the NTA Headquarters Arena, Area 11, Garki, Abuja, with the theme, Improved Technology, an Impetus for Mechanized Agriculture, Renewable Energy and Economic Development of the Nation. Date, Sunday, October 23rd to Thursday, October 27, 2016, 9 a.m. each day. As usual, this event is open only to junior categories of ages 6 to 12 years and senior categories of 13 to 18 years in both arts, science or technology. Participants must be in the school system. Are you ready to be a part of the biggest gathering of Nigerian children with creative and innovative ideas? Note, all NTA stations nationwide are implored to complete their preliminary competitions ahead of the Abuja event in October.
to Sharon Ultimate Hotels, Abuja. The ultimate place to be.
Our latest edition of TV Guide is out. This edition of your favorite magazine will simply blow your mind. The package is loaded and our offering is quite illuminating. NTA has a new Director General, Yakubu Ibn Muhammad, a tested and trusted professional, an old wine that keeps getting better with age. This is the new driver of the digital switchover train. Get to know him more in TV Guide. And now, on our cover is one of Nigeria's finest comic actors,
Afeez Oyetoro,
aka Saka. Peep into his world and you will see how he is
porting
from glory to glory. The change agenda of President Muhammadu Buhari, we did an assessment so far. All our refreshing columns and incisive features are a collector's item and research materials. TV Guide, available on your newsstands and in all NTA stations nationwide. Also, in our embassies in United Kingdom, USA, China, Ghana and Egypt. TV Guide, grab a copy and give one to a friend. TV Guide, still your indispensable companion.
Welcome back. The 2017 health budget should be open and focused on procurement of equipment, training of skilled personnel, rather than construction of buildings and purchase of official vehicles. This forms part of submission of participants after a training on approaches and strategies towards a robust budget, health budget. Correspondent Rashidat Mustafa Lagunji reports that it was at the instance of the Development Research and Project Center and partners.
Parts of the Abuja Declaration in 2001 by heads of state and government of the AU is the allocation of at least 15% of a nation's budget to health so as to address some pressing challenges in the health sector. Investigation, however, reveals that Nigeria's annual contribution from 2006 to date has not exceeded 6.10% of its annual budget, a situation that has led to inadequate funding of the sector and poor healthcare service delivery.
But in order for the Nigerian health system to achieve the results that we want to see and that the people want to see, we must do things differently. Both all of us, the executive, the civil servants, and also the legislators.
We just completed a retreat session, we've been able to put a number of plans together, which we think we eventually put before our governors to help to guide them in enhancing allocation for health.
Given the competitive nature of all the sector and non-availability of government funds, interested groups are advised to start thinking of innovative ways for fund, engage in vigorous advocacy, and ensure relevant partners are carried along.
Reducing your cost, not just of your health programs, but outside of, for example, health in health ministry in the state, you could find that if you reduce costs in other areas that are not as have a priority as health, you could now redistribute the money saved in those other ministries back to health program.
If you want to achieve health for all, then budget is very important. Funding is very critical.
Strengthening of the primary health care by bringing it under one roof and provision of universal health coverage to all, as well as quick implementation of the National Health Act, featured prominently in the discourse. About 59% of health financing in Nigeria is said to come from out-of-pocket spending by individual or family, a situation participant at this gathering said is unacceptable. They therefore called for a comprehensive health insurance for all Nigerians. From the National Institute for Policy and Strategy Studies, Guru Injos, Rashidat Mustafa Olamiju, NTA News.
Still talking health, the Cuban government is to assist Nigeria, particularly in Nasarawa State, in treatment and prevention of malaria, Lassa fever and killer diseases as part of intervention to reduce their scourge. Cuban Ambassador Nigeria Carlos Trejos Losa said this in a conversation with Governor Umaro Tanko Almakuro in Lafia. Joshua Jito has details.
The partnership between Cuban government and the Nasarawa State government dates back to 2005. and the visit of Cuban ambassador to Nigeria, Carlos Treasure Sosa, to Nasarawa State is to further strengthen the collaboration which cut across health, capacity building and agriculture. With the high prevalence rate of malaria, especially amongst children and pregnant women, leading to child and maternal mortality in the state, among other killer diseases like cancer, hepatitis, diabetes, Lassa fever, and many more, the Cuban government says it will deploy massive support for the treatment and prevention of the diseases.
I can assure you that we will do all in our possibilities to share with Nigeria, to share with the government of Nasarawa State.
Governor Umaru Tanko Almukura solicited the need for the establishment of research and diagnosis center for testing and early detection of cases of Lassa fever, as well as more technical support to boost primary healthcare centers in the state.
So I feel this is an area where Cuba can make a mark, an impression, not only in the minds of people of Nassau State, but in the entire region.
The partnership between the Cuban government and the Nasarawa State government will also be extended to the agricultural subsector. In Lafia, Joshua Ojito, NTA News.
We're joining Enugu now, where the governor has sworn in a new acting chief judge. This and more as we join Beauty. Hello, Beauty.
Yogechi, welcome to Enugu. The new acting chief judge of Enugu State has been sworn in. She is Justice Priscilla Ngozi Emehelu. Performing the ceremony, Governor Ifeanyi Ugwuanyi said it is to fill the vacuum created due to the suspension and compulsory retirement of Justice Innocent Umezulike. Ijeoma Gweke now reports.
Governor Ugwuanyi noted that the swearing-in of an acting chief judge of Enugu State became necessary after receiving the letters from the National Judicial Council on suspension and recommendation for compulsory retirement of Justice Innocent Umezulike from office. Justice Priscilla Emehelu, who he said is the most senior judge of the State High Court and having held the position of the Attorney General of the state, will no doubt do the job creditably.
I, on behalf of the government, the people of Enugu State, congratulate Honorable Justice Emehelu on her appointment and wish her success in her new assignment.
Justice Emehelu, in her response, thanked the governor for finding her worthy to serve the state in the capacity of an acting chief judge.
I will discharge my functions and duties as the acting chief judge of Enugu State creditably.
The ceremony was attended by Deputy President of the Senate, Ike Ekweremadu, Archbishop of Enugu Ecclesiastical Province, Most Reverend Emmanuel Chukwuma, and other top government functionaries. In Enugu, Ijeoma Gweke, NTA News.
A 16-day statewide free HIV/AIDS counseling and testing to check the prevalence rate of the disease and care for vulnerable groups and orphans in Ebonyi is on the way. Blessing Anyanwu witnessed the flag off performed by wife of the state governor, Mrs. Rachel Umuahi.
Wife of the governor, Mrs. Rachel Umuahi, while flagging off the exercise, harped on the need for people to present themselves for counseling and testing to further checkmate the spread in the state.
Just for you to know your status, if you are tested and yet positive, it is not the end of this life. It is not a death sentence. If you know your status, you'll be proud when somebody is approaching you. You'll be proud enough to ask the person, please, what's your status?
The Executive Secretary, Ebonyi State Action Committee on AIDS, Austin Nwazunku, applauded the gesture and other health programs of the state government, added that it will aid planning.
To what the best life has improved by enough the establishment of community action committee on AIDS that will be chaired by the traditional ruler of each community.
The award of Ambassador and Advocate of Ebonyi State HIV/AIDS Central Care and Support Services was conferred on the wife of the governor, presentation of logistic materials and disbursement of 5 million naira each to all local government action committee on AIDS and line ministries to help step down the exercise to the grassroots. In Abakaliki, Blessing Anyaun, NTA News.
Ogechi, thus our beat is back to you in Abuja for the continuation of Nationwide.
Thank you, Beauty, there. In an effort to sustain the recent improved civil-military relations in Nigeria, a roadmap to foster it has been presented to the public. Kolo Muhammad has details.
The National Human Rights Commission, in collaboration with other relevant agencies, has produced and presented to the public a document expected to repair all fractured communication and operations gaps between the civil society and the military. The Executive Secretary, National Human Rights Commission, Professor Bem Angwe, represented by the Director, Human Rights Institute, underscores the importance of greater synergy between the military and the civil population.
And this roadmap intends to develop and build upon the robust civil-military relations in the country. Worthy of note also is the establishment of a human rights desk under the Department of the Civil-Military Relations.
The National Human Rights Commission has in recent times strengthened civil-military relations by fostering sustained dialogue and improve accountability, security, and human rights throughout Nigeria.
The roadmap, amongst other things, is expected to deepen the understanding of ethics and codes of conduct between the civil society and the military, and summarily improve community-based security approach for national integration. In Abuja, Kolo Muhammad, NTA News.
While we're still talking security, EFCC intensifies war on financial crimes in the South. This and more as we go over to our Port Harcourt Network Center, where Mina is standing by. Hello, Mina. I'm happy to see you.
Same here, Ogechi. Good afternoon and welcome to Port Harcourt. The Economic and Financial Crimes Commission, EFCC, South Zone, says it has secured 26 convictions with over 1.62 billion naira recovered in the last 10 months. The head of the agency in the zone, Ishak Salihu, gave the breakdown during a press briefing in Port Harcourt. Tamara Ebiwe has the report.
Given a breakdown of its activities in the last 10 months, the South-South Zone of the Commission said it has secured 26 convictions, which is an improvement over that of 2015. The agency also recovered over 1 billion naira in both foreign and local currencies.
The highest money ever recorded by this zone from 2004 when it was established was 420 million. From January this year, we have recorded 1,060,000,000, and still counting, the year is not over. And we have recorded or secured 26 convictions.
Also nabbed was a PhD holder and a senior lecturer in a federal university, and some internet fraudsters during the period. The agency remarked that it would not relent in its efforts of fighting financial crime, in line with the vision of the current administration. In Port Harcourt, Tamara Ebiwe, NTA News.
Strategic moves to rid the coastal areas of the Niger Delta region of illegalities and criminality will continue until all unwholesome activities are wiped off. The commander, NSS Jubilee Ikara Obasi, Akwa Ibom State, Saudu Garba, said that these were parading suspects of illegal bunkering. Miriam Vincent Oko has details.
Parading the suspects, Commander NNS Jubilee Kodobasi, Commodore Saidu Garba, says 13 suspects alongside two Cotonou boats loaded with 113 by 250 liters drums of products suspected to be illegally refined automotive gas oil were arrested at Ibono local government area of Akwa Ibom State.
Most of them will tell you that this is the first time they are doing it, but I know that they've been doing this for a long time. The intelligence has been ongoing for a while, and we're able to trap them. Even their sponsors, we are after them right now. But we are working with the police because our own responsibility has a limit. So together with the police, we're sure we're going to get them.
The Nigerian Navy therefore advises perpetrators of illegal bunkering to desist forthwith or face the full weight of the law. In Uyo, Marianne Vincent Oko, NTA News.
And that's a contribution from Port Hackett. Ogechi, it's back to you for the rest of Nationwide.
Thank you, Mina. The governor of Kano State, Abdullahi Umar Ganduje, has urged youths across the country to champion the cause of positive change for a greater and more prosperous Nigeria. The governor was speaking at the inauguration of the caretaker committee of the National Youth Council of Nigeria in Abuja. Dennis Adegunloye has the report.
The Kano State governor noted that given the fact that youths make up the majority of the population, the greater good of the country is largely in their hands. He therefore tasked them to embrace positive values which will translate to a more united Nigeria. The governor urged the newly inaugurated caretaker committee of the National Youth Council of Nigeria to accept with all seriousness the challenge of taking Nigerian youths to greater heights.
First of all, you must be involved in the identification of the problems confronting Nigerian youth today in order to come up with viable solutions in consultations with different levels of government.
The wife of the Kebbi State Governor was present on behalf of the First Lady Aisha Muhammadu Buhari.
With a teeming number of people, a greater impact is required, and we need to involve them some more in the change agenda.
The national president of the National Youth Council of Nigeria, Murtala Mohammed Garba, expresses his vision for Nigerian youths.
The present leadership will work strictly on the unity of the country. The present leadership will stand to support the present administration of President Muhammadu Buhari.
Dignitaries from all tiers of government graced the occasion. In Abuja, Dennis Adigunloye, NTA News.
Senior Special Assistant to the President in Foreign Affairs and Diaspora, Abike Dabiri Erewa, has restated the federal government's commitment for the welfare, safety and education of its citizens studying abroad. She spoke when a delegation of the Nigeria Turkish International Colleges Foundation, NTIC, visited her in Abuja to pledge financial and other forms of support for Nigerian students in Turkey. SSA to the President, Abike Dabiri Erewa, condemned the sufferings being faced by Nigerian undergraduates in Turkey in the wake of the July coup, which she said have been a source of concern to the federal government. She pledged collaboration with the NTIC Foundation to fend for 25 Nigerian students in Turkey.
We will not compromise the welfare of our students. We will not compromise the dignity of Nigerians anywhere in the world. That is the policy of President Buhari. And that is the policy we are going to follow.
We thank you for this offer. We will coordinate this for you. The 25 students affected, this office with the Ministry of Education will coordinate and ensure that those students in Turkey do not suffer.
At the head of the delegation were the Vice Chancellor, Nile University Abuja, Professor Hussein Sert, and Director of NTIC Foundation, Belul Fatil Basaram, an alumnus of Bayero University Kano.
I'd like to say that the Nile University of Nigeria is ready to serve to this great country, Nigeria.
In Turkey, 29 of them has been back to Nigeria and get scholarship from the Nile University fully. And the one who is remain in Turkey, which is 25 students, also getting their scholarship from the NTIC Foundation. School fee also has been paid and scholarship has been continued till they finish the school.
A Nigerian parent of a final year student in Turkey, Dr. Yakub Al Hassan, who was on the delegation, expressed faith and confidence in the foundation and lauded the federal government for its commitment to the citizenry. Ogechi Po. The National Youth Service Corps, NYSC, in Nasarawa State has flagged off free medical services for rural communities in the state. Victoria Kashua Ojito reports that the services are part of the Corps members' community social services.
The free medical care service, which is organized by the medical team of core members serving in the state, is with the support of the state government, World Health Organization, and other health agencies. The medical care services are for the treatment and prevention of malaria, high blood pressure, and typhoid. Gidame Akoya in Lafia East Development Area was a takeoff point of the statewide exercise, which witnessed free distribution of drugs and testing. State Coordinator of NYSC, Habiba Bapa, who represented the Director General of NYSC, explained that the program is part of the scheme's social corporate responsibility to give back to the society.
The NYSC scheme, in the past 43 years, has not relented in its efforts in ensuring that its mandate is vigorously pursued.
Head of the medical team of NYSC in the state, Ayolei Adetundi, said more communities will benefit from the interventions. District Head of Gidame Akoya and other beneficiaries of the gesture all applauded NYSC for the free medical care and challenged other organizations to assist rural communities. In Lafia, Victoria Kaswa Ojito, NTA News.
As a people's government, the Buhari's administration says it will always consider the media as a partner moving the country forward. Minister of Federal Capital Territory, Mohammed Musa Bello, disclosed this at the opening of a 2016 Press Week organized by National Union of Journalists, FCDA Chapels in Abuja. Salihu Abdullahi has the report.
There is no gainsaying that Nigerian media is synonymous with the struggle and quest for democracy in the country. That explains the continuous strive by the media to uphold and protect the tenets of democracy. One of such is this forum where information officers from the Federal Capital Territory, Abuja, are gathered to build their capacity. As part of activities to mark the 2016 Press Week, among the professionals at the event is Executive Director Programs of NTA, Eugenia Abu, who guided the participants on the Freedom of Information Act, role and imperatives of information management in FCTA.
So the information managers in FCT must be able to manage information that would give perception to the public that FCT is doing something that they may not understand and be ahead of that event.
What we only need is continuous sensitization.
The Minister of FCT, represented by the Permanent Secretary Babatope Ajakai, challenged journalists on the need to uphold integrity and professional conduct at all time.
Your important role as change agents cannot be overemphasized. For instance, it is through strong and virile media advocacy that the motorist will not jump traffic or a vandal will not decide to steal cables on railway tracks.
So then in the main, we are just here as the national broadcaster. Support them to make sure that government delivers in terms of implementing policies, you know, that are favorable to the people and for the good of society at large.
The workshop, which kickstarts the FCT Press Week, attracted heads of media organizations in Abuja. Salihu Abdullahi, NTA News.
Into our global tidbits now. Burundi votes to quit the National Criminal Court, and the health of the world's longest reigning monarch, the King of Thailand, continues to be unstable. Reports say concern over his health has caused stocks of the country's currency to tumble. For more reports, let's join Ronke Kolawole in Global Tidbits.
In Ghana, fuel price may likely go up as the Chamber of Petroleum Consumers forecast the possibility of 7-13% adjustment beginning from October 16, owing to what it called the cuts in OPEC production levels, which it says has taken its toll on world price indexes. News from Burundi says the country may now pull out of the International Criminal Court as lawmakers voted to endorse a decision taken by the cabinet last week to cut ties with the Hague-based court. And now, the main suspect in the 2015 Islamist attacks that killed 130 people in Paris, Salah Abdeslam, may be abandoned by his lawyers as he continued to keep mute. Abdeslam was arrested in Brussels in March and has kept silent since his transfer to Paris in April. In Indonesia, government will now apply minimum sentencing and execution for convicted pedophiles as the parliament passes law authorizing chemical castration of rapists. human rights groups have objected to the punishment. Meanwhile, government may now relax its abortion laws in El Salvador as rape victims may be permitted to terminate unwanted pregnancies under proposals being pushed by the governing party. For Global Tidbits, Ronke Kolawole, NTA News.
Talking sports now, Nigeria Air Force games kicks off in a Katsina October 24th as one division of Nigerian Army leads in NAFEST 2016. Amanzi Makos reports.
Over 650 athletes have registered to take part in the 8th edition of the Nigerian Air Force Games, slated for Katsina from October 24 to 29. Speaking at a press briefing in Abuja, the Games Organizing Committee Chairman Air Commodore Charles Ohoen said athletes from five commands will compete in 13 sporting events.
The event is a symbol of harmony that bonds the competitive teams. It creates awareness drive both for the competitive teams and the general public.
In the same development, Minister of Youth and Sports Development Solomon Dalung has assured the Nigerian Air Force that the ministry will monitor the games with a view to identify those that can compete for Nigeria in international competitions. Dalung stated this when he received the organizing committee members who came to solicit his support for the Air Force Games.
We shall also provide technical support in areas where it is necessarily required to ensure that the competitions are free and fair.
One division of the Nigerian Army, Kaduna, is leading in the medals table of the Nigerian Army Sports Festival as at the time of this report on day 5. It has a total of 46 medals composed of 16 gold, 14 silver and 16 bronze medals, followed by Army Headquarters Garrison with 14 gold, 14 silver and 18 bronze medals. 81 division is in the third position with 10 gold, 10 silver and 16 bronze medals. Of the 19 sporting events, judo, wrestling, chess and taekwondo have been concluded, with more events expected to be run.